Java maintains a pool for integer as like string, as like string literal pool. So we'll see how integer is immutable here. But integer is a special case. Integer can be immutable only between 128 to 127 values. If we define an integer between this range of values, it will be immutable. Otherwise, it will be mutable. Suppose we have initialized integer i1 equal to 100. So 100 is between minus 128 to minus 127. So it will go to the pool. It will search 100 in pool, but it is not existing in pool. So it will create 100 and it will give it reference to i1. So now i1 is pointing to 100. Now go to this line, integer i2 equal to 100. Again, this 100 is between this range. So it will go to pool and it will see whether 100 is existing or not. Yes, 100 is existing, then it will return its reference to i2. Now i2 also referring to the same object. Now if you compare both i1 equal to i2, it will return true because they both are referring to the same object. Same object 100. So this returns true. Then next step, i1 equal to 300. If you do i1 equal to 300, Java won't change in a pool. It won't change 100 to 300. 300 is out of this range. So it will create 300 in somewhere heap, and now i1 is pointing to this 300. This is called immutability. Java won't change state of this object, but it creates a new object with 300 and it returns its reference to i1. Now again, i2 equal to 300. It is out of this range, so it won't go to the pool. It will create new 300 in somewhere in the heap, and i2 points to this 300. Now if you compare both i1 and i2, obviously it returns false because they both are pointing to the different